Hello, and welcome to Praying Parents, a show about praying for students, children, schools, and young people in our community. I'm your host, Pamela Shea, and today I have my wonderful guest, the lovely Miss Cookie West. Hello, Cookie. Hello. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you, Pam. I'm glad to be here.
It's great to have you here, and thanks so much for coming. I'm looking forward to spending this half hour with you. We're going to be talking about prayer together and following an easy model for interceding for the young people in our lives with the acronym ACTS: Adoration, Contrition, Thanksgiving, and Supplication. So let's go ahead and adore and praise the Lord our God for who He is,
yes,
His wonderful character. And I just like to praise our Lord today because God is our defender.
Yes, yes, yes.
So if you join me in opening, I will open with prayer. Oh, Lord our God, You are our defender, and we praise You and we glorify You. You protect us from danger.
Yes,
You,
Lord,
protect us from attacks,
yes,
and from all harm. You guard us and You, Lord, shield us, Lord. We thank You, Lord.
Thank You, Lord.
In Deuteronomy 10, Lord, we praise You because You are the God of gods, the,
yes,
Lord of lords.
Yes.
Oh, God, You are the great God. You are mighty and awesome.
Awesome, yes, Lord.
Lord, we praise You because You show no partiality.
Mm-mm.
You accept no bribes.
No.
Lord, we praise You
thank
because
you, Lord,
You defend the cause of the fatherless,
yes,
and the widow.
Yes.
You love the foreigner residing in foreign places, and You give us food and clothing.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, in Psalm 68, we praise You because You are indeed the Father to the Father.
Yes, Lord.
You are the defender of widows.
Yes.
Lord, You are God. You are in Your holy dwelling, and yet You are also everywhere. Nothing,
yes,
is hidden from You,
nothing,
Lord.
Nothing, nothing.
In Psalm 72, Lord, we praise You because You defend those among us who are afflicted.
Yes, Lord.
You save our children.
Hallelujah.
You save the children of those who are too much in need themselves.
Yes, Lord.
To save them.
Yes.
And Lord, we praise You because You are the defender that crushes the oppressor.
Hallelujah.
Thank You, Lord. We
thank
praise
You, Lord.
You. We bless
Glory.
You. We thank You for making all things possible and working all things,
yes,
for the good of those who love You.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So it is really a wonderful thing to have God as our defender.
Oh, yes. Absolutely. I've experienced his defending power many a times throughout my life, and it's just great to know that when you put your trust in the Lord and you allow Him to fight your battles, you know you're always going to be on the winning side. So it's great to know that God is our defender.
He is. He is our hope and our help in times of trouble.
Oh, yeah.
And just when we pray for those children who are most vulnerable and in our community, we entrust them to God who defends them.
And it's great to teach them that as well. You know, many a times throughout, you know, the years I've had to, you know, explain that to my children, that, you know, we don't respond in the same way as the world does. We allow God, who sees all, knows all, and it's our responsibility to invite Him into the situation so that He can defend, uphold, protect us, you know, from the seen and unseen. So it's great to encourage parents to do that. You know, bring the Lord into the battle and let their children know that He will, you know, provide that defense for them.
Yes, yes. And it's amazing how He defends us from things that we see and we call and ask for help. And then sometimes I've heard, you know, a couple of stories of parents praying, not realizing that their prayers were answered because God defended them from something they didn't know about.
Yes, yes, that is so true. Absolutely. And I think sometimes our children, they know that we necessarily may ask God for different things, but not necessarily know the full scale of what he wants to do for us. So, you know, to definitely to, you know, teach them the different attributes of who he is always a wonderful way to really help them develop their own relationship.
Yes.
With him.
Amazing how sometimes we take God's protection for granted until we're threatened or our children's safety is threatened, and then we realize how gracious God has been in keeping our kids and the young people in our community safe from harm, mm-hmm. that not everybody was spared. We're not immune
yes,
from harm.
Absolutely.
And to ask the Lord for safety is, it's very, it acknowledges him.
Absolutely. I mean, because we face, you know, the enemy. He goes to and fro, seeking whom he can devour. So, you know, it's sometimes we don't realize that we need to ask him every day, you know, to go before us, you know, and to prepare the way for us, you know, in each and every day, even our children, you know, and you know, it's very important, you know, because sometimes we look back at the situation. We're like, oh my, the Lord has been mighty, mighty good. But, you know, we sometimes don't acknowledge that, you know, as far as going into the situation, you
yes.
know.
Yeah, I remember going to a party one time as a young person. And I just felt a little concerned, a little, just not, it wasn't a safe situation. And I was in, just finishing college at the time. And I remember just asking the Lord, you know, to protect me. And later on, one of the young men at the party who was really not a trustworthy young man had said about me, he said, when she walked in the room, I just got struck with this fear, don't touch her.
Oh my, yeah.
And I didn't know that was happening.
Yeah.
But so I didn't know I was asking the Lord to protect me, but I didn't know how
he came with you.
That he actually he struck fear into the heart of one of these people, and I'm not a frightening person. It was just one of these situations where for some reason this young man felt a warning.
Well, that's power. That's very powerful. That's powerful to hear. Because, you know, you wouldn't have known that unless he had divulged that. But the fact is that, you know, it just gives you the evidence that, you know, he is there, whether it's, you know, he was standing behind you or whatever that case may be, that young man knew, I better not mess with her. And I think that if when we walk boldly and when we ask God to do something, he's going to show up. He's listening. So that's powerful.
Yeah. It's amazing. Do you have anything to advise to parents who are concerned about their children's safety? And I'm sure you know people who've struggled with things that are beyond their control. And have you experienced praying with people with that concern or?
Well, to be honest, it's very interesting because when my son was going into high school, I was very, he had a lot of great attributes, but he wasn't like very suave or very, he was kind of naive to situations. And so I was very concerned because one, you know, I know a lot of, you know, mothers of young women are concerned because their children are going to be going to school with older men older young men. Mm-hmm. You know, when you go to high school, you go in at 14 and you're in school with 16, 17, 18 year olds. And depending when their birthday is, they could be 19. So I was very concerned because I am a female and I know, you know, how young women sometimes can be.
Yes.
And so I was very concerned about, you know, him being taken advantage of or him being, you know, perceived in one way and, you know, not, you know, very, he just wasn't very knowledgeable about, you know, things of, you know, that maybe other people were. So I was very concerned. And I, every year, I kind of make a list of things that I really want to be fasting about and praying about. And he was, that was the number three, you know, thing on my list, to pray for him to have wisdom, to God to protect him and defend him, because not only that, he was going, you know, and where he's going to be with older males too. So, you know, this young, handsome guy's coming in here, you know, and I didn't want him to have concerns, you know, to be, you know, picked on for that. Yes. Or to, in that sense. So, you know, I was praying heavily because he was perceived as one thing, like he would be, like he was a handsome young man, very, very tall and very, he may be perceived that he had a lot of knowledge about things as far as, you know, girlfriends and all that stuff, but he wasn't. He was very
he was very handsome. He had a beautiful smile.
Yeah, he was very he was very naive to those things. And, you know, I really prayed for him to, and he was just really finding his relationship with Christ. And so I knew the enemy would be trying to fill his mind and fill other people's mind with false things. And he shared those things over his time. He shared, you know, about the different ways that he would say, he would come home and say, "I'm gonna tell you what God did for me today."
Oh,
I'd have I would have this situation, or I would have this someone tried to confront me, or someone wanted to do this or do that, and, you know, I didn't get upset, and I, you know, was able to, you know, resolve the situation. But I, you know, I was praying, you know, fervently for him to have that wisdom, him to have that kind of you know, peace about himself, and God to defend him and to become, you know, that defender if he needed to. Because, you know, we know that the battle is not with flesh and blood. We know that it's in places that we necessarily can't see, but the enemy uses, you know, human vessels to bring out those things. And so
yes.
I mean, I still have the notebook till to this day that says, pray for Lee, pray for him to have wisdom, pray for him to be protected, pray for him to not fall into temptation, pray for, because, you know, I knew that it was, you know, it was something that he wasn't really accustomed to, you know, all of that excitement going on at one in one
yes.
place.
You know, you mentioned that you kept notes for your prayer. A prayer journal, was it?
Well, I'm a list person.
Oh,
I like
wonderful.
I have like 100,000 notebooks, but I like to write, you know, things down, and I like to, you know, keep I do it now. Even like if I have a notebook or things I want to pray for, things that I know God has done. Things that, you know, I can see glimpse of things happening, and words. I mean, I like words, and to find out more meanings of them. So I do. I you know, it's important. And even with, you know, there was a movie called The War Room. She said,
yes,
you know, you need
I
to, you need
movie.
To keep. But you know what? Because we can quickly forget. You know how
yes.
far God has brought us, and, you know, the things that He has done. You know,
yeah,
you know, He's the same God then and He is now. But sometimes we, with our active lives, you know, and when things come up, we can forget, you know, those things that He has done, how He has kept us, how He has answered mm-hmm. those prayers, how He has been faithful to us. So, yeah, it's a great thing to do. I mean, you pray for something and it may not come right away. But, you know, it's nice to look back sometimes to see how far he has brought you. Not how far you still have to go, but how far he has brought you.
I think that's wonderful, because just like you're saying, we can so easily forget and lose the value in seeing how God answered, to see how He delivered us, or how He delivered our loved ones. And then to look back and be confident for tomorrow because of what God did in the past.
Yeah, I know that I would say, Lord, just protect him, keep him safe, help him to, live a joyful and happy life. And, God did that. He's in heaven, but he's happy. He's in the joy of the Lord, and he is safe. You have to really, know that God is, he's doing things for your good.
Yes, he is all for our good. So let's take this moment with our listeners. We're just going to go on to the contrition part of prayer that I encourage you listeners to do when we come to pray. And that is to silently confess our sins to the God who forgives. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and righteous to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Hallelujah.
So we're just going to take a moment to pause. Hello and welcome back. This is Praying Parents. I'm your host, Pamela Shea, and this is Cookie West, our guest today.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. So we've talked about how God is our defender, and we've been just recalling some of the great things that he's done and what he's ready to do more. So I was wondering, Miss Cookie, would you like to maybe just pray together Thanksgiving, and then maybe we'll do some prayers of supplication and intercede for our children and our schools in this area?
Sounds great.
Great. All right. Well, if you would like, I'll begin, and if you'd like to join in, that would be wonderful. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you and we praise you for defending all the children, students, young people in this Ohio Valley. We especially thank you for protecting and defending the children in Steubenville. Lord, there are so many snares, so many dangers, and yet you have raised up situations and places and opportunities for the children and students to see you come to their defense. So we just thank you, and thank you especially for defending the children from all harm and from hopelessness. Amen.
Amen. And Lord, I just want to say I'm so grateful and thankful that I have the position that I have, that I can go out through Jefferson County and, really see different children from different area schools and in their particular schools. And I'm thankful for that, because where I go, you go. And I'm just thankful that I'm able to bring you into places that can bring peace, that can bring joy, that can bring self-control, that can bring love, that can bring all of those things, Lord. And so I'm very grateful and thankful for that. And I'm thankful that you're continuing, Lord, to show young people how good you are, how you're able to protect them, and you're able to provide the strength that they need in order to move forward. Children face a lot of things, Lord, but thankfully they know that they have you with the different FCAs and other opportunities. We're thankful that you're able to go into the places, Lord, where they need you the most. So we give you thanks, we give you honor, we give you praise, we glorify your name. Amen.
Amen. Dear Lord, also, I just want to thank you for defending the students and children in this area from the terrible loneliness that can afflict them. I especially thank you, Lord, for opening the doors to bring voluntary student-led Bible studies into the Steubenville schools, into the Wintersville schools, and into the Weirton schools, Lord, and other schools in the Jefferson County and Ohio Valley region, Lord. I just want to thank you for giving them an option to come out of loneliness, to come out of an atmosphere where people don't care, and for giving the children to come and to learn from you, to learn the truth that is in your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, and to find fellowship with other students and occasionally caring adults, Lord. So I just thank you for, and also for defending these Bible studies from harassment by those who would not want the name of Jesus to be praised in public places. Public has become an excuse for creating a anti-God zone, and that was never the intention of public schools. Where there is no Jesus, there is a very, very cold and hard and harsh reality. And so I just thank you, Lord, for defending the rights of Christians to speak about what's true and good and beautiful, even if there are others that don't want the children to hear it. Amen.
Yeah, and we thank you, Lord, that you are giving the administration the, you know, they're getting the green light to be able to do these things, that they're looking at the whole student and they're trying to build and nurture their whole student, understanding that our students need character education. They need a sense of hope, and they are allowing these courses or these opportunities to be there. And we're thankful for that. And we're thankful in advance for all the things that you have done and you're going to do from this point on, Lord. We're very thankful for that they will stand bold, they will stand firm, and not move on this, Lord, that they will, it will stand the test of time. So we're thankful for that and for the victory from now into the future. So we're thankful for that. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So supplication, interceding for students and children and those who care for them. I would like to begin maybe referring just from Psalm 35. And I'm actually going to pray for my son Michael and ask, Lord Jesus, as you have arisen and you are alive, I just ask you to rise to Michael's defense. Contend for Michael, my God and Lord. And Lord, I just ask you to bless him and protect him, even when he doesn't realize he's in any danger. Lord, protect him from things both seen and unseen. Lord, I just ask you to defend him from loneliness and defend him from confusion and defend him from being misdirected or drawn into anything that is a distraction from your divine and wonderful purpose for his life, Lord. So I just thank you for Michael, and I ask you to bless him and continue to protect him as you have been so faithful. Amen.
Amen. I'm going to pray for my daughter, and I would say, refer from Acts 26, it says, open Lexi's eyes and turn her from darkness to light and from the power of Satan to God, so that she may receive forgiveness of sins and place among those who are sanctified in faith in Jesus. And I'm thankful, Lord, that you are continually opening her eyes to see who you are, to get a deeper and a more rich relationship with you, Lord, as she is transitioning in her last months of middle school, going into high school next year, and just going into a a new place as she is, you know, transitioning into her teenage years and into adult years. Lord, I ask that you just go before her. Defend her, Lord. Give her, Lord, the ear to hear your prompting, the ear to hear your whispers, you know, Lord, of harm and snares and traps by the enemy. Help her, Lord, to be a light in amongst of situations that are dark. Help her, Lord, Father God, to be immovable and steadfast and abounding in your word, Lord. Help her to see, Lord, the enemy's traps and snares, and help your word to rise up in her and to lift that standard, Lord. So even though this weapon may form, it will not prosper. So I'm thankful, Lord, that you're already going before her now. Even now, Lord, you're going before her, helping her to prepare herself for her new beginnings. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. And Lord, I just want to come into agreement with Cookie for, on behalf of Lexi, Lord, and I just praise you for putting Lexi in a high lofty place for your glory, Lord, and I ask you to continue to defend her from your enemies, just like in Psalm 62, where King David was really asking you to protect him from those who would push him from that lofty place, Lord. So please protect Lexi from those who would topple her from a lofty place, even if she is leaning or tottering, Lord. I ask you to gag the mouths of those who would speak lies to her. I ask you to confuse those who delight in lies, and fill her heart and her understanding with praise and confidence in you. Amen.
And I want to just say a quick prayer to say, Lord, just continue to, you know, keep your hand upon those young people who are transitioning from a middle school to high school. It's going to be an overwhelming time. And we're asking you, Lord, as they transition to, you know, raise up those leaders who can lead them into your arms and to lead them into a righteous path. So, Lord, we thank you for going before these young people and to raise up those young people you've ordained to help lead these young people into a path of righteousness, a path that reflects and loves the Lord and has a pleasing desire to do your will. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. And Lord, I just ask you to continue to bring revival and spiritual awakening on the school campuses in the Ohio Valley region, especially the schools in Steubenville, Mingo, Wintersville, Toronto, all up and down the Ohio Valley. Amen.
Amen.
And Lord, I also ask you to continue to broaden the cover of prayer in this area and inspire more parents to pray for schools so that every school will be covered in prayer. Lord, please protect all praying parents and keep them untarnished, pure,
yes,
steadfast, committed,
mm-hmm,
consistent, and
diligent, mm-hmm,
in partnership and
yes,
agreement with
yes,
others.
Yes.
Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Well, thank you. We will thank you so much, Cookie, for joining us today.
My pleasure.
And to saying goodbye, this is Pamela Shea, your host, and this is Praying Parents. Thank you. God bless.
God bless.